Alright, all the framing in the rear is done, the wiring's done, and I'm getting ready to put the insulation on. I'm going to be using this Loctite spray adhesive. I put it on both surfaces, sort of like what you do with contact cement, and then stick it together. I've actually found better stuff than this before. I think the spray contact cement works better. I thought I'd try this because it's Loctite. I don't like it as well, but it does the job. So this will be the last time I buy this stuff. But the 3M spray adhesive, I think it's red in color, so it's only red in color, so you can see where you've sprayed it. I think that works better. Also, the stuff that you use to spray on the back of canvas for painting, to stick it to the board that you put canvas on, I guess. That stuff works. I've used that. I used that on the Forester up in Colorado. All right, so yeah, that's all we're getting ready for. We've got the curbing in. Edge board, if you want to call it that. I like calling it curbing. That's all in. Three layers, a quarter inch. Buy non-knotted material. It's expensive, but you know, you're only going to do this once. In the scheme of things, it's not that expensive. One sheet is, I don't know, I think I paid 20 bucks for this. So, without the knots, it'll bend without breaking. If you buy the stuff with the knots, then it'll break at the knots when you bend it. So three layers of quarter inch thick works great for that. That's when you have a three quarter inch wall. On the Forester, it was an inch. I ended up using two layers of 3/8 and a layer of 3/4 inch, something like that. I don't remember now. But yeah, there's all kinds of different combinations you can use for that, just to get whatever thickness you need, all the way down to 1/8 inch. This piece that you see in the middle here is for the license plate, and the wire is in there for the light, the running light for the license plate. We have the wires coming out the sides here for the running lights. So it's all ready for the insulation and the vapor barrier. And then that metal over there will go back on. At a later date, he may pull that metal and put new metal on. We don't know yet. All right. I don't know if I've shown you this before, but I just feather off about an inch worth of this stuff. Maybe a little more, because you can always pull more off if you need to. But get it started. Just pull it. Just like this. Go ahead and spray it. Yeah, I don't even like the way this sprays. I like the way the 3M sprays better. Remember, it only has to hold it long enough to get the vapor barrier on, or the condensation barrier, whichever you want to call that. So you don't need a lot. Now we put it on. Like that. And we're going to cut it. Start on the end here. Right, you know, just on the outside edge where it hits the wood, where it hits the curb, is a good place. As long as you got a, you know, something solid to put your knife against, see? Like that. Okay. same thing here. We find the bottom, cut right along the edge. And we just tuck it in there like this so it's not overlapping the wood. Now for the wires, we'll leave those hanging out and they will go. Lights are somewhere right around here. Stuff holds pretty good, actually. And we'll cut out for the lights when we actually go to put the metal on. Now, I did get it a little thick when I was pulling, separating the two pieces apart. And so, it usually does this. It doesn't separate evenly all the way across. But that's okay because it squishes in and it kind of gives you the puff factor, you know? But if you feel you have it too much, go ahead and peel another layer off, if you think you can, to make it a little thinner. Sometimes you make a bigger mess this way than some of what you're doing with. But it can be done, see? See what happens? Also, so you have to be careful which direction you pull it in. So this is always an experiment in process when you're dealing with this stuff. I usually just leave it. Make for a nice puff factor. If you think it's too thick, go ahead and peel some away. There. Leave it. Okay, we do the same thing for the rest of it, and then we put the vapor barrier on. Okay, here it is with all the insulation on, with the vapor barrier on, and the wires hanging out. So. Now I'm getting ready to attach the rear metal. And we're putting the old rear metal back on. He may change that later. But right now the old rear metal is going back on. The front's getting brand new metal. You want to play. You think it's always playtime, don't you? Yep, you sure do. Nope, can't do it. Gotta work. Gotta pay the bills. Got all your socks there, don't you? Boy, you're just having a blast. When I pull a piece of metal off of a trailer and put it back on, of course, everything has to be resealed so it doesn't leak. Because I've got all new wood under there, or I wouldn't have pulled the piece of metal off. Well, if you're going to pull the lights and so forth, it's ridiculous not to make them completely functional and clean them all up, you know, rebuild them if necessary. So, that's what I did. I took all four of these lights off and cleaned all the terminals and stuff. And even down inside there, you know, I've showed you this on Trailer Tidbits Electrical. You use a regular car battery cleaner. You go down in there and clean it like that, see? All right. Also, these wires, they pull out and they pop up. You can clean the terminal ends also. And I used wire brush for that. It looks like a toothbrush. Of course, you wouldn't want to use it on your teeth. Where is it? It's over here. There. You can buy these at the auto parts stores for pennies. I think three of them for a buck, something like that. So you want to clean all that stuff, and you want to put an extra screw in here that makes good contact with the metal and the back of the pan so that you have a good ground. So, at any rate, yeah, just something I wanted to show you because I have to show the owner that I did this also. So it's all sealed up now, resealed and tight. I don't know how many of these bulbs are good. He might have to get new bulbs. They look good to me. The only way to really find out is to light them up. I might do that too, I don't know, we'll see. They're easy enough to change if not, so but I didn't say I'd get them new bulbs. The other thing is, these are Bargmann 99 lamps, tail lamps. This one is good, the screws are all there and they haven't been busted through, but the other one, they have been busted through. As you can see here, you can see all the way through there now, and so you have to use washers and longer screws to keep them on, or you can buy new ones at Vintage Trailer Supply. They're really expensive too. I think they're about 20 or 25 bucks each. The whole assembly you can buy there for the Bargmann 99s, brand new pan and everything, all new, you know, brand spanking new with the lamp, the lens, for 50 bucks. I think that's what it is. It's either, yeah, I'm pretty sure that's what it is. $50 per lamp, I think. I'll double check that. Yeah, they have both available. They have the single light backing plate with a single bulb and the backing plate with two bulbs, the two bulb assembly. The ones I'm dealing with on this 57 is a single bulb assembly. And the light bulb itself for that, if you need it, because they have the pins that are opposite each other and they're not staggered up and down, they're evenly spaced. You can get those at the auto parts store. They're made for Toyotas. They only made them for 2 years. And in my other video where I show you how to rebuild lights in the trailer tidbits section, it has the number of that bulb. I can't remember it offhand. So that you can ask for it by number. But you can buy the lenses for $16.99. There's the Bargmann lens, $99. Or you can buy the complete assembly for $53.99. That's for the two bulb conversion version, or the single bulb, let's see, the single bulb version for $39.99. You can also buy just the back plate or just the lens, you know. So anyway, yeah, also this one has these guys, these little Trail Light 99 one bulb assemblies for $49.99. make sure and look at the dimensions for all this stuff before you go buying it. They have the Stratolite 42 marker lens too, which is what this trailer needs, and he'll need to order some of those and put them on there because his are faded. Okay, we got the rear on. I'm happy. Lights are all rebuilt, cleaned up, checked, rechecked. Should work just fine. So there. Getting real close to the end of this one.